Hello everyone, hello and welcome to the second part of our Let's Play Resident Evil Code Veronica Rex A Rank playthrough, folks. I am the Black Shadow, and yes, last time we proceeded through the first half of the game. We didn't do too badly in the end, folks, all the way from our very first zombie, all the way to Steve crashing the plane in the Antarctic facility again, in 1 hour 54. Which is not too bad, actually. I'd say it's slightly better than par. I'll be really honest, folks. I was aiming for an hour 45, actually, for that first half, actually. But I suppose, you know, I made a couple of errors and mistakes, and if you took out a couple of the optional things that I did do, you probably would hit that. But, you know, 4.5 hour time limit, I think, is a little bit on the generous side, more or less. So I think it allows you a bit of maneuverability to do a couple of extra bits. So, you know, that's how I look at it. So now, folks, it is simply from here to the end. We have got to go all the way. We've got to go through the Antarctic facility with Claire. We've got to go all the way with Chris through the military facility, back at Rockfoot, back through the Antarctic. We've got to take over Claire quickly and then go with Chris all the way to the end of the game, folks. And if my maths is correct, that leaves us 2 hours 36, I believe, in order to do that in, assuming that A, my maths is correct, and B, that the game is counting at the same speed as my stop clock, which we don't know. I can't guarantee that's going to be the case, actually. Now, we're coming up, actually, to probably two of the, probably the, I think, most important parts to this speedrun. Claire running through the Antarctic and then Chris running through the military facility, I think, are the two most important. It's the two areas where you're quite likely to lose time. It's very easy to lose time in the Antarctic because you get bogged down with, you know, moving a lot of items around. And as it comes to well with Chris, knowing what to do in the best order as well is very, very important. Start forgetting one or two things, start having to do a bit of backtracking, you will lose time very, very quickly, folks. So when we do get to that bit, I'd very advise anyone doing this, unless you feel absolutely convinced you know what you're doing, make a list of it. And I will go through the list of things and how to proceed through the military facility, folks. I've boiled it down to about 8-9 different points. And if you can do those, then that will get you through, and that helps you stopping yourself from getting sidetracked, more or less. Just the main point is just to go through. So I'm going to quickly get my my phone, because that's my stopwatch, and I've left it in charge, and then we will be back and to start on. So 2 seconds. Apologies for that, though. I just smacked my knee on the chair on the way back. That really hurts. Ah. Okay then, folks. So make sure you're settled in once again. You've refilled that cup of drink. You got yourself everything you need to go. A couple hours spare to not get interrupted. At least a couple hours. For this is going to be the run to the very end of the game, folks. We're doing alright time-wise, but it's not amazing. I'd like a little bit more than what we've got, so we're going to have to, you know, keep our wits about us, and we're going to have to be pretty swift nonetheless. So here goes. And we are off under starters onwards, folks. So as per usual, cancel everything. No, keep pressing select. Get past all those cutscenes we don't need. So Steve, crashing the aircraft. Can't use it, and also, oh, goodness sake, Steve, trying to play more games. We'll go with that. Right, now the first thing I'm going to do, which is again a little bit optional, because if you go by the two halves, we've got about 15-20 minutes spare, actually, is I'm going to pop into here very quickly. I don't want much of the stuff that's in here, actually. A lot of it's not important. All I'm here for, mainly, is handgun ammo. Of which there are 3 boxes, one on that bed, there's one on the left side in this bookcase, and there's one on the locker on the right. There is also a first aid spray, but of course we don't want that. So say no, and it will still offer us the handgun bullets. Very good, thank you. And I actually do also want to get hold of these, the bowgun powders, because they'll be quite useful for the final boss. To go along with the Magnum and anything else I decide to use. So they should prove very useful. We're going to need to get hold of a couple of quivers, actually, for the bowgun. Just normal arrows, because otherwise we're going to run out of stuff for that. Zombie ambush, but as per usual, just use the automatic function. Burst your way through the first zombie and run out. We don't need the map. We don't need the file. We don't need anything else that's in there. It's not important. Just run away. There you go. Nice and easy. I mean, this burst handgun is just such a... It is so good. I think it is so, so important to the speedrun, folks. I mean, because without it, you've basically just got to try and run past everything, which is not easy. Or you've got to spend ages trying to kill it. I mean, this allows you to just take it down and run, which is what you're really after. Really useful. Right, so grab bowgun arrows. I'll grab the herb here. That's one good thing, actually, looking at so far. I had a little look at my inventory before I started this. We've actually got a fair amount of health, actually. Actually, I'll push this back now while I'm doing it, though. You know, you can't do anything with it at the moment. There we go. That's fine. So we'll drop. So do a quick bit of moving around. And yeah, see, lots of herbs actually. So drop that, drop that. We can probably get away with nothing at all on us. Because we're about to get a lot of health, so, you know, right, we'll be okay. But yeah, the main real important thing to remember this first time round is just is remembering to keep going, folks. It's very easy. Just disable that. It's very easy to get sort of carried away with bits and pieces. It's remember to just stay on task, stay focused, and keep doing what it is that you need to do. So I'll take out that zombie. I also want to take out this one as well, but they're the only ones I'm really interested in taking out. The rest aren't really very important. The rest we can dodge. They're the main two. Ooh, let's not go that way. There we go. I'm going to head into the weapon box room this time first. Because I want to do this one first. There's, That's the Magnum, which obviously we can't get right now, but we will get later on. Is there any ammo left in this? No! I mean, look at that. That is so, so good. So, so good. So, grab hold of the mining room key. Also, remember to come this way, folks, so we can grab hold... Ooh, that was a bit close. Shouldn't have done that. To grab hold of the assault rifle for Chris later on. Very important we do this. Though there's actually nothing else we need to do in here, so we're just going to leave. There we go. Just had to get around. Very nice. Idiot. So, with that in hand, now we want to head into the BOW room with our lovely spiders as well. Isn't that amazing? Now again, not interested in the slightest in actually dealing with these guys. Just come over here, grab the two boxes of handgun ammo. We aren't actually going to need to grab too much more handgun ammo, really, folks. Oh, quick turn and run away. Managed to get out of there before being grabbed. That was close. Grab the barcode sticker. There are a couple of herbs in here, but to be honest, it's gonna... Ooh, goodness. It's gonna be quite difficult getting hold of those without getting into a prolonged fight with these spiders. So, it's only a green and a blue. We should be okay about them, so I'm gonna leave them. Right, so we'll pop down here. Put the barcode sticker on that. Very good. So that can be sent off in a short moment. Use the mining room key up in here so that we can then work on getting the power on. So move on here. Head into the doorway, which is so hard to see unless you actually look at the map. And of course, there are a lot of items here that I know you can't see too well when the lights aren't on, but that doesn't mean you can't actually pick them up. You still can. Just you have to find them yourself. Green herb, green herb. Couple boxes of handgun ammo as well. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Now, the dogs as well. Just drill them full of ammo, folks. Don't even... I'm not even going to entertain them. Trust me, we can afford to be... You know, we can afford to use this handgun. We've got loads. I mean, come on, we got 200 bullets in reserve, for goodness sakes. We can afford to use this. There you go. No, I mean, that is so efficient. It is just a joke. Grab all the herbs in here. Very nice. And then we'll swing into here. One more dog. Nearly said zombie. Well, zombie dog. Turn the power on. Lovely! And, yeah, I'm just gonna... Don't think there's anything else. Oh, no, there is. There's one more herb in here, isn't there? Yes, that one. Nearly forgot. God, I mean, there's loads of health, folks. You really do. I'm actually going to probably keep all of this on Claire for later on in the game. Instead of having to put it away to put it bring it back out. Because there's actually enough health in there for Chris. Make sure, for goodness sakes, make sure you come here and check the valve pipey handly bit. Make sure you do that. Very important. Just look at it so we know to cut the valve handle into octagon later on. Otherwise, that is a lot of time you're going to waste. A lot of time you're going to waste. Let's just quickly... I'm just going to combine these up into a bunch. Because we've got a lot of green herbs lying around in the iron box. We've got about 6 or 7, which is really good, actually. And a couple of full heals as well. So we're doing good on health, which is nice. We're going to need it later on. We got some nasty stuff coming up, of course. Turn the power on for the sorter. That will move our magnum box, but obviously we can't access that yet because we can't. You move the lever to move the BOW box into the BOW room so that we can then get hold of the gas mask, which obviously we need. And, ooh, this could be entertaining. Trying to dodge that. That'll do. Just go around him. Bit hard to tell quite where he was, but, well, it worked out. So just head in, grab the mask, and leave. You don't have to entertain those spiders in the slightest because they're a pain in the ass. Lovely. So that's all done down here. So also now we've got the power on, we can now head back to the locker. We can now activate the switch in that so we can get hold of the... ow. Have I just poisoned myself? I think I've just got poisoned. That's a pain in the ass. Not a disaster. There's blue herbs later on. Yeah, poison! Damn. Right, put the assault rifle away. Let's just move this out of the way somewhere. There we are. And actually, thinking about it, folks, I'm going to put this away as well, the handgun. I know it seems a little bit crazy, folks, but we actually... We don't need the handgun anymore, actually. We can get away... I'll have the knife on me just in case. But we do not need the knife at the hand of us. There's the D to the I to the J to the freaking mouse who somehow knows how to write a book. Crazy fucking thing. So now we can activate this. But yeah, obviously, speedrun, I am actually going to give Chris the custom handgun because it's awesome. In case he needs to use it. There and there is, of course, there's Alexander with... what would appear to be a case of severe intestinal difficulties. Doesn't sound too pleasant. I wonder if he makes that sound every time he goes to the loo. God knows. Machine room key is the more important thing we need, so let's get out of here. Wait, I'm going to leave that with Chris, just in case he needs it. Although, actually, thinking about it, he might not. But, you know, we'll see how things go. It's a just in case, you know, in case things don't go quite as I'm planning, because, you know, you've got to have a plan B. When you're doing this. I mean, I know it's a speed run, but you've got to leave yourself at least a little bit flexible, because if things start not going your way, then you're in major, major trouble. So we use the machine room key to get in here. Yes, very good. I love the music in this game. It's awesome. Right, head over to here so that we can now get hold of the valve handle. There we are. Very good. Lovely. Head back out. There's Steve. Yep, who, Steve, attempts to land the digger, crashes because he's busy staring at Claire, unleashes toxic gas, they run out. Claire says not to worry, but we all know that Steve just cannot keep his mind on business, can he? I mean, for goodness sakes, man. Goodness sakes. We all know it's his fault, so, hey. Right, so we head into here. So grab all the stuff. Yep, zombie. Yeah, you can't touch me. Blue herb, and there's a green herb in here as well, which I'm going to grab. Yes, I know about the machine. Thanks for that, game. Use that. Use that. Well, I think it'll be okay. Put in the valve handle. So we can then cut it into an octagon, because we know to cut it into an octagon, because we looked. Please, please make sure that you check that, because it is really, really frustrating if you forget. And you're like, oh no, I've got to go all the way around. And if you're busy trying to do an A-rank way through, that is a lot of time lost. Octavalve handle, thank you. And the handgun ammo, I'm actually not going to bother taking, folks. I don't think we're going to need any more handgun ammo for the rest of this game. I think we have got enough. Honestly. I really do. Now, I know leaving the handgun, I mean, look at that down there. You know, there's lots of zombies there, actually. You might think, well, you know, what are you doing, Sherry? You're just going to have fun with that. Well, it's not actually as bad as it might seem. I did a little bit of looking at this before I started this. And also, this is actually my second attempt at recording this this second part, because I did die during the first, which was quite frustrating. You can get past these zombies without being grabbed. It's not impossible. Get the fuck off me! It's not impossible, folks. There is a way of doing it, and if you watch carefully, you'll see. There is a path that opens itself up. Now, if we go by the cage, get past him, squeeze up against the wall, and you can get by him. It is doable. It's not the easiest of things, actually, but it is there. It is there. And so with that, we can now leave. Nice and easy. So we'll put in the valve handle. There we go. Alfred shows up, tries to shoot us. Steve shows up, saves us, shoots Alfred. Alfred falls into pit of despair. Angry noises from Alexander, who then goes gets out to go onto a path of rage. And that, of course, leaves our sniper rifle. And yeah, I noticed that, folks. You can actually, you can walk during that animation. Weirdly enough, you can't run. You can walk. Very strange.
Claire, what are you doing? Let's go.
Shut up, you.
Are you ready? I'm gonna.
Yeah. So skip all this. And they obviously dig out, flood the facility. Eventually climb up the helipad. Steve tells us to get going, so we do. And Steve gets bashed in the face for his troubles. Not for only boss fight time! Now, very important here, folks. Do not get poisoned. Do not get poisoned. If you get poisoned... That was a shot. If you get poisoned, it is time wasted that Chris does having to get hold of the serum, so... Oh, missed. Back away, so please don't get poisoned, otherwise it's a lot of time that you're going to use up in helping Claire. Oh, that'll do ya. Come on, Nosferatu!
I've got you now.
Fucker! Have that! And yes, I'm happy to spend 3-4 seconds watching that, because it's fucking awesome. Nosferatu dead. Keep slamming the select button. They drive out, get assaulted by Alexia, who then revives and attacks him through the vines. And then, of course, folks, we resume control of Christopher Redfield back at Rockford. Oh, yes. Rodrigo, awesome. He must be saved after getting attacked and eaten, effectively, by... the Galt Worm, which sucks. So we're going to save his life. I know technically this boss fight is optional, but you know what, I don't care. It is worth your time saving him. So I'm going to drop all this. I'm put that away for the moment. First aid spray, put that away. Grab hold of the assault rifle, and we are good to go. Lovely. Yeah, as I said, I know this boss fight with the Gutworm is technically optional, but it is worth your time taking them out. Just like the main playthrough, folks. It is worth your time. It's not too difficult to take out this guy. It doesn't take very long. And to get hold of 3 set of submachine guns? You're telling me it's not worth your time killing them? You gotta be kidding me, folks. You gotta be kidding me. So take out this guy, you don't even have to be looking at him either. Just whenever he comes up, shoot in his general direction. There we go. Come on, you. Well, there you are. And just fill the sumbitch with lead. See, didn't take very long, does it, folks? Grab hold of the lighter. Rodrigo has sadly dead. Oh, I hate seeing Rodrigo dead. Oh. And we'll head back into here. Lighter in hand. And of course, use it over here. You can just use it straight away without you looking at this stone. It all drops down at the same time. 3 submachine guns for what? About a minute's work? You come on, folks. I mean, seriously. Right, so put that away. That is all we need, really. I'd argue we probably don't even need the extra green herb, but never mind. I'll deal with it later. So now. Now begins the pathway for Chris through the military facility. I would suggest if you're going to win or lose this A-rank playthrough anywhere, it will be here, that it will be won or lost. But I'm here, I will give you the exact fit list of what to do and when to do it to make things as quick as we possibly can. So... if you want to, well, the first thing is to take out the Galt Worm. So we've done that. He's dead. So number 2 is we need to get hold of the battery. And we need to get hold of the battery so that we can get access to the second floor and thus a large part of the facility. That's the first thing we have to do. So to do that, we need to go away. We need to head out to the backyard where the tank is. And as you remember from where Alfred doing it, which is the clue, we need to come over here and push the button on the back. Anytime today, please. Thanks. Lovely. So we head down the lift. So, head on down here. Grab all the shotgun shells and everything that's here. I mean, honestly, folks, I would, if you've not attempted this sort of speedrun on this game before, I would honestly suggest make a note of what, if I remember, I'll put up the annotations, the points that I'm saying for the facility, because I think it is that important. But honestly, folks, make a note of them, please. Please make a note, because when you're trying to run like a crazy person, it is very easy to lose track of what you're doing, and you do start making mistakes. I still do them. I have been doing them. You saw it earlier on. So please, 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 be careful. Right, combine all that up. Because we got loads of green herbs sitting on their own. Acid rounds. Don't know how to take them. They're here, so I'll grab them. And shotgun shells and some hangar bullets, which I'll grab because they're here. Don't have to worry about the drawer puzzle, obviously, because that's not important. Yeah, the Luger replica you don't actually need, so, just grab that. Okay, put that away, put that away, put these away, that, and that for that. We want two green herbs on us. Do we want two? I've got two. Actually, I don't need two, I only need one, actually, thinking about it, but never mind, I've got two. I'll keep the shotgun shells on me, because we're going to be grabbing those as we go along. And I because we're running along with effectively less stuff anyways, I can afford to keep the shells on me. It does work itself out, folks, honest. Oh, and I've made the first mistake already. Head back down the stairs, go get the battery from the freaking doorway. You see, it's that easy, folks, to get sidetracked. It is that easy. That's cost me a few seconds. It's that easy, folks. Ugh. Grab the battery. There we go. Spider attack, of course, which isn't so great. And he's a pain in the ass to try and run past, so I'm just going to kill him. Oh, you scumbag. Pain in the ass trying to run past him. It really is. Spider. He came from behind. I wasn't expecting that. Good lord, I thought he was going to come from in front. Oh, goodness. Okay, so there's the point. So we've got the battery. So now we've actually got the battery, then obviously place that into the place that it needs to go, which is the lift, which is up here. Which is also part two as well, because it's the same thing. Past him. Watch out, there is a zombie here actually, which is quite a pain in the arse. I would probably recommend dealing with him, but I'm getting charged by that one as well. Didn't appreciate that. Good lord. So place the battery in there. Very good. So we'll climb up with it. And we will grab the... Remember to grab the control key, the chemical key from the left. So, point number three on the list, folks, that you need to do. The next thing you want to get done is to get hold of the doorknob. That is the next thing that you want to get done or need to get done. Because you'll find when you do this, it's just a giant list of key items, one leading to another. It's all it really is, folks. So it's just getting them in the right order. So the doorknob is the next thing you want to do. Yeah, Alexia singing. And then Wesker, well, being a bastard as usual and sending Hunters after us, not fun. Now, you do have to make one slight decision here, folks. There's a side pack not too far from here. Do you get it now or do you get it later? I'm going to get it now because I've worked up a few minutes in the last part as it is. So I'm happy to spend a couple of those minutes getting the side pack now. I mean, just run across. It's not too far. It'll take a minute or two to do, but I think it's worth the time. Like I say, if you've worked up enough of a headway, then you can do it now because there is always loads and loads of items and all sorts of stuff that you need to pick up when you go into the basement, and you always end up struggling for item space. So I would probably recommend getting it now, so it's not a worry. It's not far. Just deal with all them. There we go. And just come over to that, grab the side pack, and you don't even have to fight anything else here. And run. There you go, nice and simple. And it just say, I mean, we've got to come this way, obviously, later on to put the actual doorknob in the door. But, you know, I don't think it's that much work, and it makes life a lot easier later on, rather than having to juggle around item space. Because when you start juggling around item space, you have to start backtracking, and that is even more time lost, so we don't want that. So, point number three is get hold of the doorknob. To do that, we need to head down to the basement. Don't bother heading to the first floor because there is absolutely no need to go down there at all. Not a sausage of a reason. Not even a teeny weeny weeny little one. Not even. So don't worry about that. Head straight to the basement. Obviously we can't head through the doorway because it's all gassed and everything. So we want to head down here instead. And grab hold of Old Faithful. Thank you! So that'll raise that up. Now there is a variety of items here, some of which you might want to grab, some of which you might not want to. I am going to take a moment, again, you know, I'm happy to get hold of these. The two red herbs here. I mean, it's two red herbs, folks. Come on! You really think I'm going to pass up two red herbs? I mean, are you serious? Are you for real? So find those up. There we go, lovely. Now this zombie does get up here, so just be aware of that. But he will never ever be a problem for us ever again. So don't worry about that. There are some handgun rounds. There's also some flame rounds there as well off on the shelves. But I don't really need either, so I'm not even going to grab it. I don't need the handgun round anymore. We've got enough of that. And the flame rounds, I don't really think I'm going to end up using those. So, again, I'm not going to bother. This is where you've got to start making decisions, folks, over what do you and do you not need. Because if you just keep grabbing everything that you come across, then you're going to end up just, you know, it's yeah, just don't bother, folks. If you grab everything, you're going to run out of time. Now, although we are here to get hold of the doorknob, do not get hold of that first. You actually want to head left first. Head into the chemical storeroom first. And there is a reason. And quite an interesting one. You want to do this first. We head in here. Shotgun shells, thank you. Doing quite well on the shotgun round front, actually. Yes, use the storage key. Yep, discard it. Set the temperature to 12.8, which is obviously to reflect the opening date of December 8th, or August 12th if you're in this country. Silly Americans. And we'll get hold of our Clement here. Clement Sigma. Now, if you get hold of this Clement before you get the doorknob and alert all the Hunters, that sweeper that comes out of that vent doesn't ever appear, and he won't bother you. Make sure to do this first. However, unfortunately, there is not a lot that I can do about this, and it amazes me when you do this, folks. This is such an important part of the game for the game that it has three different cutscenes for the beginning of the Hunters. That is how much the game hates me. Period. Shoot as fast as you can! Make sure to turn! Is he? Oh, he's dead. Oh, that's a good result. Imagine him in six! Not bad, Shadow. Lovely. Right, so we got the doorknob, which is good. I'm just going to bring this down now. I'm not going to grab this assault rifle ammo yet. I'll do it a little bit later and you guys will see why. So now that we've got hold of the doorknob, we obviously now need to put it into the door. Which is back up where we get the side pack, which is a little bit of a trek. But it's not that bad. So we'll re-equip that, combine it with that, and then put that inside. Lovely. So obviously we have to put that away for now, because we need to head back upstairs, and we haven't been able to screw around with the stuff yet. Cool. So, we'll head up to where the side pack room is. Also where we found the crossbow with Claire. Back up the second floor. So we can use the doorknob. Seems so bizarre, this, going all this trouble just for a freaking doorknob. But as we have established, unfortunately, this is Code Veronica, Chris. This is not Resident Evil 5, Chris, where he would just simply punch the door down. You know, he hasn't gone on that steroid trip yet, so... although we have, as we have also established, courtesy of this game in BS Inc., obviously, it is Code Veronica X that forces Chris to go down the steroid route, because of the fact he just can't match up with Wesker's pure strength now that he's a superhuman. Don't we like it when everything ties together? Of course, be careful in here because the cameras, the hunters are around, but this one, if you just run straight forward, it'll never touch you. You're fine. Take a bit more care on the way back, folks, though, because otherwise you will run into some trouble. So, put in the doorknob. Lovely. Make use of that. And then that allows us to get hold of the fourth point. The tank object. And I'm sure you guys can probably guess the port point now is to take the tank object, take that down to the first floor to put into the little dioramery room with the pictures and the all sorts of stuff. And to put that in there in order for us to then start screwing around with all the lasers. So that's your fourth point. Go back down to the diorama room. I'll be careful here. Just let it go upwards like that and you can just sneak past the near wall. You've got a lot more room to move around that corridor than you actually ever realise. It's just, it's kind of a bit hidden, actually. And so all the way back down to the first floor. So what are we doing for time? Not too bad. First floor. Make it that we've got about 2 hours left to, by my count, we've got about 2 hours left in order to finish the game, which, should prove interesting. Careful of the camera here. Just let that turn itself off. There we go. 2 hours left. This could get a little bit tight if I'm not careful. So, go over here, place the tank object into here, which is good. Which then reveals the puzzle behind us. And then, the fifth point on our little checklist, folks, because that then gives us the turntable key. And a file, which we don't need. We don't go. So, obviously, then, check notice number 5. We now need to take the turntable key to the turntable, which is back down into the basement. And then we need to use that, obviously, to take the turntable up so we can access the rest of the facility. And also so we can access the airport so we can get hold of the three armies proofs that we require. So we can then disable all those lasers. So that's good. So point five is to, yeah, use the turntable key. At the turntable, back in the basement. So swing on down. Those at no point so far have I actually had to also go back to the item box, folks, because I've just kept myself running very light. I've actually got... I usually would have more space than I actually have, because I've got the extra herb, but, you know. So that's actually not too bad in the end. Yeah, well, that's alright. 65% of the submachine guns is alright. So run up here. Finally, Chris meets Wesker. We punch him in the face, reveal some creepy fucking eyes, and Bandersnatch fight. But the submachine guns makes very light work of it. It really does. Now I'm going to grab hold of the assault rifle bullets too. And now we can use the turntable key. Right there. Lovely. Turn it up. Awesome. So now, with that, we can take the turntable up. The sixth point now. Number six, I suppose, on the list. I don't really know what to call it. Actually, just so you know, I am actually going to grab those explosive powder rounds that are there. So I'm going to do that quickly. It didn't take very long. But now that we're up here, the sixth point on the list is now we need to head to the airport to get hold of the three army proofs. Navy, Army, and Air Force, if I remember correctly. And so that is the next thing to do. Come up there. Very nice. Lovely. Not going to head into the little side room yet, because we need to do that later on to get hold of the other Clement. Clement Alpha, but we don't need to do that right now. Be careful here, but with a bit of careful running and dodging, you can get past him. The one behind you runs immediately, but if you wait for him to jump in the air and then turn, then he can't touch you, because he's in midair, and he can't change direction while midair. I'd like to see you guys try and change direction midair. I know birds can change direction midair, but that's because they're cheaters, so they don't count. So anyway, so that takes us back down into the to the airport, folks. It's nice, I ain't been here for a while. That's what it feels like it. Very nice. So we will screw around with our inventory a bit here. I'm going to drop the submachine guns for the assault rifle. The Clements, we can drop this for the moment. The bow gunpowder can be dropped. I can probably drop one of these. See, look at all that health. That's ridiculous. And that should be good. Just remember to have free spaces to obviously grab the free proofs. Sorry, I just punched the mic there. Sorry. Now, of course, be careful when you come out here, because hunters and lots of them. Oh, that's not fun when they start diving up in the air. That's never good. And keep firing until that some bitch is dead, and you know he's dead. Do not stop. Because I ain't fucking playing with those things. They could go straight to hell. I mean, actually, truth be told, the assault rifle might actually not... It's probably not the most effective weapon to actually use against them. Actually, probably, thinking about it. Alright, so obviously, before we can get the army proofs, we need to do the oil pressure puzzly thing. So, an easy way to get past this, like I showed it. So, Fill it with the 3 to have 3 in the 10. Fill it with 3 to give you 6. Fill it with 3 again to give you 9. And fill it once more. Empty the 10, and that leaves you 5 plus 2, which is 7, which is the exact number that we need. Easiest way of doing it, surely. And just do the... And there you go. Nice and easy. Job sorted. Leave zombie ambush. Shotgun shells, which I do want. You don't have to do this, but I want the shotgun shells badly. Ow. When did that happen? Oh, yeah, of course. Bye. Bye. And I can probably grab these without even having to deal with the other zombie. Ooh, just about. Oh dear. Yeah, I want to get hold of as many shotgun shells really as I can. Or try and get hold of a load. Because I'm hoping that that means I can just run around with the shotgun later on in the game instead of screwing around with like handguns and whatever else. So now with the oil pressure sorted, we can now get hold of the army proofs. Which is good. Find that. Remember to get the assault rifle back out as well. So now we're going to head back downstairs. Of course, be careful with this guy because this hunter is not fun. Guys, drop down. Wait for it a sec. Wait for the footsteps. Is it dead? No. It's dead now, I think. There you go. Nice and easily dealt with. Just what we're after. Bind that up just to save a bit of ammo there. Oh yeah, shotgun shells here as well. I forgot about that. Damn it! Be careful of shooting him as well, or continuing to shoot, because of course he has got those explosives on him, and you do not want that blowing up in your face. So be very, very careful about that. Very, very careful. Hunter in here as well, of course. Use that little flicking technique that I showed about. Just tap down on the D-pad. It just alters the angle you get to shoot at. Ow, that hurts a lot. Ow! Freaking hunters are giving me a nasty time today. It feels like they're giving me. That feels like they're giving me a lot of hassle. Which is never good. Grab all the free proofs, army. Navy, Air Force, and that's awesome. So now we've got these, now we can leave the airport. The 7th point is not to, we're not actually going to go straight to the first floor here, folks, to put those iron proofs in, because, whoa, that wasn't a good decision. Because before we do that, folks, we need to get hold of the Clement Alpha. So we can combine that to get our deployed or duploid or whatever it's called. So we can then combine that with the Hawk emblem or whatever it's called, the blue emblem, so we can get hold of the gold halberd, so we can leave. So the 7th point actually is to head to the to get hold of the Clement Alpha back in the basement. We're going to do that first. We're going to do that now because it will save you a lot of time. Because otherwise you just have to backtrack again. Which you cannot have any of. I'm going to grab a couple of green herbs actually. I'm going to use 2 I think because those jumping slashes really freaking hurt. There we go. Now, I don't have any blue herbs on me at the moment, so I'm going to have to be really, really... I should have grabbed the green and blue there, actually. Just in case. Because if I get poisoned here, then that's, that is a bit of a problem that I've just ended up getting myself into. How good is my dodging ability, folks? If it's any worse than it was last time, I'm dead. If it's any better, we may have a chance. Here we go. What can we do, folks? Go in between. In between! Dodge the first one! I've been hit. I don't know if that was poison or just the jump slash damage that did that. I don't know. I honestly don't know. What's the damage report? Damn it! Poisoned! Ah! Pain in the ass. Ah, darn it. It was too late though, folks. By the time I realised I was already in the lift, I couldn't go back. Right, so now things are going to be interesting. Sit down. Grab all the shotgun shells that are here. There's some acid rounds in the locker there, but I'm not going to grab them, because I don't think I'm going to need them. Ah, dearie me, Shadow. What a mistake. Right, well, this is going to certainly hinder things now. There's that zombie there, who is still attempting to grab my leg. I mean, he needs to get a better job. He really does. He needs to get a job. So, raise the lever up. So that will obviously fan out the place. Get rid of all the poison gas and stuff. So now we can proceed through here. And I'm hoping I don't have to shoot any of these guys. Except for this guy who's going to have to die up here. Preferably so that he's dead. Which he is. Okay. I'm going to have to use the health. I've got no choice here. I'm not playing games with this hunter. I'm not even risking it. I don't know what health we're at, but it can't be good. Again, just tap down the D-pad. It just changes the angle. And look at that. He's dead. Nice and easy. No, just don't even screw around with it, folks. So head through here, grab hold of the Clement Alpha, which is here. I know I could have bought that, well, you don't need the, to be honest, you don't need the custom handgun. You don't need it. So grab hold of the Clement Alpha so we can mix that with the Clement Sigma, so we can get the Clement Mixture, which is we can do in a short moment. So now we've got the Clement Sigma, making sure there's no health. Now we've got, oh, the Clement Alpha even. Now we've got hold of that, the 8 point now is to head back to the diorama room and to put in your free army proofs into the little puzzly machiney bit. Oh, Shadow. Which obviously we want to head via the stairs so we can keep the shotgun. And so we want to do that. I'm going to have to be pretty swift about this, actually. Because there is a blue herb to get, but that's not actually until after we put in the army proof, so... Anyways, head to the first floor to put in the things. So put in the free army proofs, which are here, army, navy, and air force, and whatever order it is that you desire, it doesn't really matter, just make sure you do it quickly. And lovely, put the lever down, And the diorama will go back to reveal the ladder, which is awesome. Come back here, grab hold of everything that's here. Green herb, as well as the shotgun shells, which actually, folks, on my last playthrough, I discovered there's actually two boxes of shotgun shells here, not one. Not on the last playthrough, but on my first attempt of going through this for the A rank before I died later on. I actually found there's two cases of shells there, not one. Which I always thought there was one, so there you go, folks. It's extra rounds for you. You know, extra little shotgun shells each, which is like an extra gold nugget each. Grab hold of the other green herb, because we're going to need it. I don't care about the grenade rounds. I honestly don't care about them. I'm not going to use them. I promise you I will not use them. So grab hold of the blue herb, which I'm going to use immediately. Yeah, I knew I'd take a bit of damage from that. And I've only got the three green herbs here, so not amazing on the health front for what we're about to do. Unfortunately, unlike when we did this the last time, there's our medal, or emblem, with the adult albinoid boss fight. Unfortunately, I can't pick my spots really too much here and try and look for a good opportunity to get hold of the emblem. We've just got to kind of go in and do it. You can kill this thing, actually, apparently. I was looking into it. Apparently, you can actually kill this thing, but I didn't know that. Ow, ow, get it quickly, because I think it's turning to, like, assault us, like, physically. And, oh, that's not too bad, actually. One electric shock. That is a superb result. That is a really good result, that. Very pleased. Very good. Couldn't have gone much better. Very happy with that. No. 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 Get! I can't run past this guy. He's very difficult to run past. And I can't kill him! Oh. Very awkward to run past that guy. I've just decided I was going to kill him, but I didn't mean to get grabbed like three freaking times. Oops, sorry about that. If there was a slight interruption to the video there, sorry about that. And so now that we've got hold of the emblem, now what you want to do is combine that with the clamp mixture, which I accidentally didn't take the other part of the mixture with me, so don't worry about that. Head to back to where the tank was, which you need to do via the second floor. Head back down the lift there and get hold of the gold halberd, but combining the emblem with your mixture, get the gold halberd and leave the Antarctic. And that, folks, is the I think that's not well, nine, I think it is. It's a 9-point plan for getting through this place with Chris Redfield as quickly as you can, because it is very easy to get bogged down with everything that's going on. That is about as easiest a way I can physically think of putting it. So, spraying ground here, then we've got to go back this way, back to where the tank was, and leave. And all of that, folks, in pretty good time, actually. I don't have the exact timing on me, unfortunately, but that couldn't have been much more than half an hour. I mean, that's not bad. That is a hell of a result. Run past him, just about. So unfortunately, I've got to head back in here quickly to get the clump mixture, which is a little bit of time wasting. But, you know, that's just unfortunate. And if any other change I want to make to this while I'm here... where is it? There it is. So combine those. I've got the herb. Grab that with me as well. So there's your clan mixture. Combine that, the eagle plate, to get hold of your owlbird. And you are rocking! How much assault rifle ammo we got left? 13%! Not even worth taking with me. I'm going to drop this now. I'll drop it back down for the submachine guns. Grab the shotgun for now. I mean, I'm not really interested in using up the rest of that ammo. I mean, it's kind of a bit, kind of... It's not really worth it. It really isn't. And put in the halberd. And we are out of here, folks. Let's fly to the Antarctic. I make it about 1:40 left on the clock, which isn't too bad, actually. 1:40 left, and we've got Chris to the Antarctic. That's not bad going. Still can't hang around, though. I have a feeling this is gonna be a bit tight. This. I'm gonna be using up quite a lot of that 1.5 hours, I think. Oh, curses, whatever. Right, get rid of that. Maybe I should have used the rest of the assault rifle for dealing with these frickin' vines. I'm not using the shotgun, the submachine gun, it's too important. That wasn't ideal. I should have kept the assault off of me just to finish off those things. Oops. Didn't think of that. Sorry. Alright, anyway, so... First thing we want to do is to head downstairs one final time. Make sure, don't head down the left to the towards the herb planter and the door, because it is a trap. Do not head down that way at all, for any under any circumstance, really. Put the halberd into here. Which allows us to get hold of our bits and pieces. So, paperweight. File, which we have to take, unfortunately, but I don't care. And there's also some ink ribbon, but we don't need that. Let's drop that. And I'm gonna put the paperweight away, because we don't need it at this exact moment in time. We don't need it right now. We'll pick it up later on when we do. Just to save on a bit of inventory space, because we've only got 5 spaces on this, which isn't amazing. So anyway, so let's run up here then. Nice and quickly. Well, as quickly as the game will allow. Thud. Thud. Sort of thing. And so we need to head onto the second floor. Because obviously now the facility's frozen, this is the only place we can access it. So we'll head this way first so we can get hold of the valve handle. Very good. Grab hold of that. Thanks. Grab hold of the Octavalve handle. Run out of here. And yeah, folks. We can't even skip this scene. We have to watch ourselves get ambushed by zombies. We can't just accept the fact. We're not even allowed to watch it out of choice. We're forced to watch ourselves get ambushed. That sucks. Ooh, nearly. Well. I don't know how it didn't survive the headshot, but hey. I'll be careful, folks, as well. While you're here, very occasionally a zombie might, like, something might burst out of it and start, like, attacking you. It's got to do with, you remember those little, the little flying poisonous things? They're trying to put eggs into stuff. It's to do with that, folks, basically. Some of these zombies have been infected by them. And if something bursts out or starts flying, you just keep slamming the X button and you'll eventually get it off you. Just be careful of that. Yeah. Headshot master at work. Goodbye. That was a double headshot. How did I manage that? Odds on a postcard. So grab all the dual looming case. Make sure to grab all the dual looming case. Handgun ammo if you still want it, but I don't. But yeah, I mean, make sure to grab that dual looming case because it does carry 6 magnum bullets in it. Make sure to grab that. Well worth your time. Swing on down to swing up. Ooh, giant spider. Ooh, yucky. Wesker! No, you do not! Stupid thing. Don't bother heading into the double door room yet, because it's, yeah. You don't need to do that. There's stuff to do, but we can't do it yet, so ignore it. And we don't have the fire extinguisher on us anyway, so don't worry about that either. So head down here. I'm gonna kill this fucking thing right now. Wherever it is. There it is. No. Yes, there it is. I think it's dead. Yeah, that's dead. Lovely. Wanted to kill that damn sweeper right now while I was going past. Pain in the ass. So we'll re-equip the, no, don't check it. Re-equip the shotgun, because we're going to need that in a short moment. Right, so we need to come over here first. And use the octavalve handle. To reconnect the power supply. There we are, lovely. And then come over here to turn the actual power on. Flip the switch. There we are, lovely. Quite a few herbs down here, so I'm going to grab these. And I actually do want to get all the blue herbs. We've only got, like, I think that's only the second one that we've actually... I think we've got one in the box and one on us. Blue herb wag, which is a little... I wouldn't say concerning, but I mean, it's not great. It's not a good situation. There is some shotgun shells here, which I'll grab. Doing really well on shotgun ammo here, which is actually very pleasing to see. It always is very pleasing to see. Put the dual looming case away for the paperweight. Health, I'm going to put a lot of this away. Don't need that. We don't need that. Put some of the herbs away because we're about to grab a load. Octavalve handle, I can probably put the submachine guns away thinking about it. Yes, we can put those away too. And the shotgun is going to stay on its base for the rest of the game now. So I'm just going to make it look all nice right now. Don't do that. Okay. So that wasted time, fine. Ugh. You can't help OCD, folks. I'm not actually OCD, it's just... I just like it looking like that. Always have done, always will do. You ain't gonna change me. Grab blue herb. Headshot city! Yeah, that's what we're talking about! Goodbye. Look, Ma, no frickin' face. Goodbye. I will see you in the afterlife. Jackasses. They never learn. So that takes us into here. So we want to swing around immediately. And we can start screwing around with the old lion statue. Grab the blue jewel first. Well, I'm going to. That will give us the socket. Yes, it seems to work by electricity. Well done, Chris. It's not done by frickin' magic. And we'll get the right one, because that has the not critical to game winning, but pretty much it, the Magnum rounds. It's one of those things where you don't necessarily need it to finish the game, but you might as well. Put those back. So a bit of putting the items together. So that with the valve handle. Lovely. So we head down the lift. My ear is still getting a little bit itchy. I do apologise. A little ruffling the headset and everything like that. I try to avoid it where possible, but there you go. I need a drink. Right, so we'll head into here. Yes, giant, massive, freaking ant hive. Disgusting. And we'll grab hold of the first of our weak objects. Run past that. Green herb. Thank you. How did I run through without getting attacked by even one of those? How did I manage that? Thanks, gamer, I guess. Oh, the suspense. The drama of it all! You could cut the tension with a butter knife. Any time now, game, please. I have a speed run to complete. So we'll swing up here. Yes, folks. This one. Heart, spade, double A, crown. The code, I'm pretty sure, is double A, crown, heart, spade. Basically, of the original code, it's the last two and then the first two. Yes, I did work that out before I did this. Put your paperweight inside. There's Alfred. You can only skip it there. Alfred appears. He's dead. He looks like part of his bottom section is actually missing there. But obviously it's not. It's just it's the same colour as the smoke. And why not? I'll do this bit now. Alfred's joke. Thanks, Alfred. See you next time. And so with that done, you do not even need to head down the other side, folks. It's not important. There is like some handgun rounds and maybe a herb and a file. Don't need to head down that other room. Do not bother. Because there is no reason to. I didn't even really need to in the main playthrough, just for the file. That was it. So don't even bother. It's a waste of time. Time, ammo, and other things that you will never get back. Like your patience. So with all that done, we can now start gearing up for the business end of the game. With an hour and a half left to go. Which is alright. So I'm going to swing into here. Because before we get right down to the business, there's one couple of more things we have to do first. And that is that we still need. That we don't really need at this exact moment. We can put this away for that. And that as well, actually, because I'm going to do a bit of combining quickly. And I also do want to get hold of the submachine guns, which I will do now. Lovely. Love this music so much. Okay, anyway, so let's head back upstairs then. No, we can't head back upstairs! I left something! Oh, darn it, I got too carried away. Freaking sing along to the music. Let's sing along with the Black Shadow and forget why what on earth it is we're actually doing so we can complete the speedrun. Darn it. Darn, doubly darn. Because we forgot one quite important thing, folks. One very important thing we might need, and that is the fire extinguisher. Yeah, we need that desperately. So now with that in hand, now we can... Actually, tell you what, folks. Oh no, we can't do that yet. No. I just thought of something that I could possibly do to save a bit more time, but I've realized it's not going to work, so ignore me. It was to do with, like, cutting off the power, and I've realized it's not going to work, so don't worry. So I thought, oh wait, hold on a sec, this elevator runs on electricity as well, we kind of need this to work, so... Yeah. Not good. Don't know if that... I assume this elevator also runs the same electric power board. I believe it does. Ooh, that was quite close. I probably advise you wait before you start trying to run past that one next time. Don't do what I did, because that was quite reckless. Right, so push the switch to bring up our drum of fire extinguishment. Bit of a mouthful there. Bit of a mouthful. Use that. There's our extinguisher. Very good. Also going to climb up here as well. With submachine guns equipped as well, thinking about it. And with the square valve handle, not the octagonal one, place that in here. And that will drain the water tank. So that we can get hold of the crane key, which we require. Game, thank you for that. Sweeper ambush! But with submachine guns in hand, not a worry. You see why I spent a minute fighting with the gulp worm to get hold of the submachine guns. It speaks for itself. I do not even have to defend it. That is how awesome it is. I do not even have to defend it. It defends itself. So we're going to swing down the lift here. Technically optional, but in reality, you know you need to do this. Come down here. Use the refilled extinguisher to put out the fire. And a grab hold of the granddaddy of them all. Our Magnum. And so all that leaves us to do now is to get hold of Alexander's jewel, which we will do. Yeah, careful of that freaking robot. But if you are quick, you can get past him without alerting it. Let's head over here. Sorry about putting the crane key. Alexander rises, Alexia laughs, giant ugly spider boss time! Except we don't have to fight this guy either. Run past, come over to Alexander, and grab his pierce. Ooh, ugly boss. Come on, which way are you going? Ah, there you are. Ah, I can get past you now, you jerk. Ooh, ugly boss. Ooh. Yucky, yucky, yucky. do not approve of that. And now our robots disappear, which is nice. Yeah, speaking for a long time is an interesting concept. I wouldn't say my voice is going, but starting to feel the effects ever so slightly. But it'll be fine, because I'm the Black Shadow and I will not let anything get in my way and all that kind of stuff. Do I need to screw around with anything inventory-wise? Nah, that'll be fine, I think. So we come over here. Grab hold of the wing object, which only shines... These only shine the light because the light's actually on. Otherwise, I had a little look. I couldn't see them in the dark, and I couldn't seem to pick them up. But that, I don't know if that's just because I was looking in the wrong place. Because I didn't actually... I did not genuinely remember where on earth they were, so... I was guessing. Magnum in hand. So, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to come up here first. I'm going to do this bit first. Because we need the combat knife, which I could have brought with me thinking about it, but I didn't. So I put in Alfred and Alexander's jewels into the relief, if you want to call it that. Grab hold of the combat knife, which obviously we need for downstairs. Now, the great thing with downstairs and helping Claire out now, because I didn't get poisoned during the Nosferatu boss fight, we do not have to spend time having to get the serum for Claire. And also, when we take control of her, she will not be in danger. So that is more, more health saved, which is awesome. Save Claire. Claire's fine. Nice to see you, big brother. And Alexia appears. Beats the shit out of the staircase. Take over Claire. Steve is in severe trouble. And we are back with, you know, the angel of death herself, Claire Redfield. That I love that. The Angel of Death. That is just so awesome. So, all we need to get here is the... oh, goodness me. Remember to... Oh, yes. Remember to do this as well. Goodness me. Remember to open this with Claire. For goodness sakes. Grab all the Magnum rounds for Chris. Combine them with those. We need the custom handgun, the bullets, and a fair dosage of health, which luckily we've got. And that should be all the health we need. But I'm going to take an extra green herb with me just in case. Take a green and blue. We've got a few of those now. Not going to bother with the shotgun placing on the hook because we do not need the grenade rounds. And I could have picked up the handgun rounds but forgot and now can't be asked. Managed to run past the first one. I can never seem to run past this one though, so I'm not going to bother. And just fill it with lead. There you go. Glad I bought that extra herb now. That was an informed decision. So we'll run through here and enter probably what is now going to be the most dangerous phase of this entire playthrough. Is basically the next 10 minutes. If you can get past the next 10 minutes of the game, you're fine. Turn the handle, and for goodness sakes, please be careful here. It is too easy to get caught by this freaking thing. Too easy. Grab the crystal. Rebecca, knee! That's scary. Now, run underneath, over the little circly bit in the center, place the crystal. And you're fine. That'll raise itself. Get hold of the security card. The mechanism locks above you. So that's fine. Super. What's this? I don't know who that zombie is, but he's not in the way anymore, so I don't care. Head into here. And then place the security card in. And now we... So that's the first really dangerous part out of the way. The second part will tell you just how well of a speedrun you've done to date. Because it is that freaking dangerous. There's Steve. All hell about to break loose. Quick turn and run. Ow. How good a speedrun have you done? Have you got enough health to run? Ow. Oh, keep running, Claire. Yes, very good. And I might have had an extra bit of health there, but I honestly don't care. We're alive is the main thing. So, Steve obviously dies there. I love you, Claire. Back with Chris now. Unfortunately, I have to skip the fight scene between Alexia and... Whoa, and Wesker, unfortunately. I have to skip that. I'm so sorry. Boss time. Second, really. Oh, no, I missed the Magnum shot. What have I done? I missed the Magnum shot. Oh, my God, I missed. Oh, my God, what have I done? Oh, boy. Yes, she's down. Is that down, down? Please? Yes, she's down. I nearly screwed that one up. Oh, goodness me. That was awfully close. Oh, goodness. I thought, missed the Magnum shot. I'm going to get caught in a corner and destroyed. Because this is where I died last time. I got caught down the back and died. A bit of a disaster. I got caught right in there. Absolute disaster, folks. But we got away with it. So that's alright. Right, so there's Alexia's jewel. And that allows us to gain access to here. That is so ominous. So ominous. Right. Which way do we need to go first? We don't need to head that on our right immediately, do we? Don't think so. Lots of zombies to make our way through, though, here, which is probably going to finish off the sharp machine gun ammo. Anything in here that... I do forget a little bit what we needed and where. Not good this. Nothing. No. In here? Ha! This is what we needed. Biohazard key. This is what we needed. So we got that. That's the important thing. So actually, with that, we can probably just go and use that immediately. I'm going to finish off all the zombies in here, though, first, because I want to. And that means I can just put away the submachine guns and they're done. They have to die anyway, so... He's not dead! He's dead now. Tell me that guy wasn't dead! Run back down. Take out the shotgun. Yeah, that 1%. Use the sterile room key, biohazard key, whatever you want to call it. Now, obviously, we can't get hold of the jewels immediately. that we need for the rooms, because I need to turn off the power first. So they'll do that bit now. I'll tell you what, we're not doing too bad here. We're doing very good on time now. Actually, I've got through this a lot quicker than I thought I would. Pretty happy with this half so far. As long as I haven't died yet, so that's a good start. Okay, so let's sort this all out. So, put that away, we need the wing objects, and then this is health, and actually I'm going to do this bit now as well. Just so I don't have to do it later on. Because I don't think there's any more bow gun powders that I remember. I don't believe there is. So, we've got that. Health, wing objects. Pretty sure it's everything we need, because I can. Because it's awesome. And I think we are largely good to go. Not entirely good, because we still have to work through these bits. I'm going to pay one more visit to the item boxes before we... oh, shit. Power, yeah. Well, A, I was running the wrong direction, and B, I need to turn off the power. But as we're doing, on my count, very good on time, I can afford to make one last dive into the into an item box at the end. So there we go. That'll be basically the last time we ever hear that music, which is a shame, because I love that music a bit. So, the power's off, everything stops. If you haven't seen the wing objects yet, then you have trouble seeing them in the dark. I don't know if you can pick them up in the dark. I don't actually know. I've never tried. Shadow, where are you going? I'm getting ahead of myself now. So easy to do. To just get ahead of yourself. You're constantly having to think, what do I need to do next? What do I need to do next? That you end up start doing the things you need to do next before you've done the first bit. Ugh. Grab the two jewels. Doesn't really matter. Yeah, make sure you got two spaces as well for the two jewels, which I didn't even register to have two spaces for the two jewels. It just worked out that I did. I didn't even think of it, so yeah. Look at this place, is an absolute mess. You know, half of it's been destroyed, parts of it have been set on fire. Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa! Whoa, what was that? Good Lord Almighty, that gave me a fright. And I'm going to use one of these now because we might have some lingering damage, which I'm just going to do now. Good Lord, what was that? Bloody heck. Right. So we'll put the blue jewel in here now. Might as well. That's exactly the frickin' same. Bunch of frickin' nutters. Good thing one of them's dead and the second one's on the list. Yep, stop music box. We need the red jewel, obviously, to, or the red ruby, whatever you want to call it. Red ruby, blue sapphire, whatever. Put them in. Open the box up. And Bob's your uncle. Please do note, folks, a disclaimer, if the name of your uncle is actually not Bob, then BS Inc. do not take any responsibility for the fact that that's not actually the case. So that'll lower down Alfred's bed. It's a good thing Alfred doesn't listen. I hope he doesn't listen to this music while he's actually freaking going to sleep, because he'd be just be crushed, wouldn't he? Ah, la-di-da. Oh, why is that coming down on me? Oh, dear. Splat. See, they don't think of these things, do they, the Ashfords? Good thing the Redfields are on hand. So we'll swing around. Get hold of the dragonfly object. That's the one. Of course, we're still missing one of the wing objects. So we can't... Well, if you want to try putting them in now, you can. But what's the point? Do, 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 ring. And actually, in all that, I didn't even open up the door on Alexia's half. I didn't even open it up. I didn't bother. Now we're heading to here. There's a... Is that a file? I think that's a file. Button on the panel. Open it up. Little cryogenically chambery thing. So we can get hold of... the final wing object. Combine that so that we can get hold of our proper dragonfly. Don't think there's anything else here. No, no, no. Let us leave. Yeah, that is a file on that. It's not a briefcase or something like that. It can't be a briefcase because we don't get any control glare again in this game, which kind of sucks. Combine all that up. There we go. Very nice. Unlock the door. And so what I am going to do... Before I... Oh, have I got to really... Oh, of course. I didn't do it with Claire, so I've got to deal with it now. Whatevs. Yeah, sod it. As I will delve into the item box here now, because we have got the time to do this. And I'm going to sort out the inventory for one last time. So, that is going to go away for the... Oh dear. That's not a lot. Ooh, actually, I've left myself a bit short here. I'll grab that, and that, and that. I've got one spare, which I'm going to use anyways. Oh dear, I've not... This is... this is interesting. And we need a space for the security card, don't we? So that is... that will probably have to do... Four full heals. That should be enough. Right? Take the fifth one with me, anyways. Should be enough. Alright, it was enough in the first playthrough, but I did get through all of them. But to be fair, having the actual standard grenade rounds might be of use actually in the final boss rather than having like the flame rounds. Thinking about it actually. Yeah, Claire. Upset. Yeah, we can't take the file. We will have to we'll have to go before. Fine. Fit security file. Awesome end game music, as always. And that gives us the security card. Love it. This is awesome. Sorry, the music's so good. Head up here, folks, of course. We want to put in our gold dragonfly. Very nice. Head inside. But yeah, we're past the worst. Now we just got to make sure we just don't die, basically. Goodbye. Take those guys out. Actually, yeah, probably having the grenade rounds. This is probably actually more useful having this than the flame rounds. Actually, thinking about it. Lock release system. Please enter the security code. Of course, the patriarch of the Ashford family. And of course, in true Resident Evil fashion,
this facility will detonate in 5 minutes.
Ridiculous! That 5 minutes? That's like, that's ridiculous. I mean, isn't that like kind of assuming that everyone is out of there already? I mean, 5 minutes. Feel sorry for the bastards that are still down, you know, in the basement working. God help them.
You made it.
Of course, Claire arrives. Save Claire's life. Wrong button. Goodbye. Pathetic. Alexia goes crazy and all, like, I'm gonna kill everyone and stuff. And it is final boss time! Once again! Unleashed with the... Oh, ow, the magnet. Now, I've had a thing about this, actually, thinking about that having the grenade rounds might actually be of some use here, because all these little things will start slowly ganging up on me. Oh, shit. Grenade rounds, shoot the ground. It'll kill them all, won't it? Genius! So it just helps keep them all at bay, because you take a lot of damage from those little things, actually. A lot more than you might bargain on. Poison?! I can be poisoned?! Oh shit! I didn't know that! Oh my god, I didn't know I could get poisoned! I was not aware of that, folks! Oh man, this is gonna make things difficult. How do I keep track of my health now? Sit down, you piece of shit! And I make it linear launcher time! I tell you what, that is fucking effective, that bow gun! Oh man, that is super effective! Alexa, you are going down for the second time, for the last time! Where are you? Show yourself to me! How high up is it? Is she? Oh, I missed. Darn it. I don't have time for missing. Oh, come on. Stop dodging, you bitch. Ow! Don't set me on fire either! Oh, don't you play these games with me now! Yes! Fuck you! Fuck you and your family. Mash the select button. Keep mashing it. Unfortunately, I have to skip the Wesker Chris fight scene, which we all love. I'm so sorry. Keep smashing that select button, because there are so many cutscenes. That's four. I mean, there's about six or seven of them. It's ridiculous. I think that's Claire going back to the plane. You gotta make it, Chris. Yeah, Chris and Wesker busy fighting. Explosions. And that is as far as the select button will take you, folks.
Chris, where are you?
I don't think you can skip anything from here, folks. So at least you get the corny ending.
Chris!
Hey, you know that I always keep my promises.
God's sakes! Chris! No wonder Wesker hates you so much sometimes!
Chris, promise me. Please promise that you won't leave me alone again.
I'm sorry, Claire, but it's not over yet. There's still something we've got to do.
God, really?
Yeah, it's payback time. We've got to destroy Umbrella. Now, let's finish this once and for all.
Where is the barf tin when you need it? That's barf spelled B-A-R-F. A capital bath. And that rolls us into the credits. Which again, you cannot skip, folks. But that is that. And yes, the game basically makes you wait and sweat it out as to whether you have done the game quickly enough. Because it's an arse like that. But, yeah. I think we've done it. I'm sure we have done it. If the game tells me now we have not done it, I will be very, very, very upset. I may have to kill someone. There may be a shooting in Milton Keynes. You never know. It may happen. It's happened once before. I think it's only ever happened once in like 50 years. We've had this. You know, which is, may seem crazy to some, but yeah, I mean, what, it's about 50 years old, I think, Milton Keynes. There's only one shooting that I've ever heard of there ever being here. That was a few years ago. That was a pretty awkward situation, but yeah, if the game tells me that I've not got an A, there may well be a second. And a third, and a fourth, and a fifth until the Black Shadows Rampage is eventually ended by armed police. But don't worry, I'm not just going to go around shooting random people. I will make sure that I target only tyrants and despots. General bad people. You know, like a vigilante justice sort of thing, you know. I mean, shooting people's not good, but if you're taking out bad people, does that make it better? Moving swiftly on. Yeah, so I think that's pretty much it. So, give me 2 seconds, folks, and I'll let the credits play out. I'll be back in 2 seconds.
Friendly but naive.
Boobies, let's sing along with the Black Shadow. Darn it! Never mind, we'll have to make do, as you guys get to see lots and lots of cutscenes that we didn't even get to see during the speedrun. Because that's just, you know, that's how it is. Oh, Alison Court, thank you very much for repeating your Claire Redfield role from Resident Evil 2. Pretty sure it's the same person. It sounds like the same person. I think she's probably probably the only character, I think, that's probably had the same voice actor all the way throughout. I mean, the only one I can think possibly might have been Jill, I think. But other than that, I'm pretty sure they've all changed at some point. I mean, Count Dracula's, Wesker's voice actor in this game is Count Dracula, and I'm pretty sure he didn't get picked up for Resident Evil 5. Or Resident Evil 4, for that matter. Either that, or he stopped that creepy freaking laugh. I mean, what on earth, folks? I mean, what has he been smoking? Seriously. I mean, the T-Virus makes you into like a superhuman, not a freaking vampire. There's a difference. Goodness sakes. Oh, so annoyed I couldn't show you that cutscene, folks, the Wesker fight. I really wanted to again. I never get tired of seeing it, but unfortunately, you know, what can we do? I must admit, folks, actually, I have no idea whether the counter keeps playing through these last two, through the credits and that. I don't actually know. I've got my counter still running, so if it is still counting through the end, it'll probably be reflected in my timings. But again, it's not, you're always sure, because you don't always know how accurate the cane counters can be in games. They can always be a little bit fast or a little bit slow. I mean, by my count, I make it that this has gone, we've done it in about 3.25 hours, actually, which is really good. Or at least by my count, 3.25 hours. I don't know what that means in game time, but in my time, that's awesome. That is really awesome. Alright then, folks, it is time. It is, yeah. How have we done, folks? How have we done? 3:42, 3.75 hours, whatever. It says an A. That is all I... Oh, yes, of course it is 3.75, isn't it? Yeah, my bad. That was my miscalculating my part. I'm not sure if the, I think the talent does keep going through the credits, just so you know, but it's an A rank! No saves, no retries, no first aid sprays, and a lot of ass kicking. And that is, that's the A rank run through, folks. Lovely. That is it, really. It's not impossible. Look at that! 3.75 hours! You get the rocket launcher for completing the A rank run through, which everyone can now screw around with, playing through the main game, which is a lot of fun. However, yeah, folks, that is that is the A rank run through. I hope some of you watching through this will have picked up a few things that you can do and not do in order to help you get through. Especially if you're sort of stuck on that sort of the five and a half hour boundary, just can't seem to get past it. I'm hoping there's something there that perhaps you can use just to get your time down just that little bit extra, just to what you need, I hope. However, that is that. Like I said at the end of the last video, if you have any questions at all about anything, please ask, and I will do my best to answer and hopefully I can help you guys out as well. I hope, you know, if you've managed to find a way to play along with this and watch this along with playing along, then I hope this helps as well. And I really do wish you guys all the luck in getting hold of that A rank playthrough and get hold of those 100 G's for you. However, that is all that there is time for today, and of course that is going to be the end of our Code Veronica LP. Thank you guys very, very, very much for watching, as always. I hope you've enjoyed it. It's been a lot of fun on my end. It has been wonderful. Even in the midst of some pretty awkwardness in regards to the fact I'm still using a different PC to a normal one. So, not 100% sure how things are going to roll from here. I'll probably put up an update video in a couple days or so to let you know what's going on. Because the next thing that is due is the subscriber special playthrough on Resident Evil Remake. One Dangerous Zombie. Which is next year up, along with still with the X-Files, which I didn't do alongside with this because, due to technical issues. So both of those will be on their way hopefully very soon. But I'll put up a video about that in the near future just to keep you guys updated, because I can't give you an exact time frame because I just do not know. So hoping it won't be too long. Maybe a few days at best, I hope. But we'll have to play things a lot by ear, I'm afraid. But anyways, folks, so that is going to be all. So I will thank you all very, 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 very much for watching. Hope it helps. Thank you so much. You've been as wonderful an audience as ever, and I will see you down the line. So thanks a lot. Take care. God bless. And I'll catch you then.